This is one of the best ways that I've seen Apple Notes used ever. Forever Notes is a brand new framework and system that you can use with your Apple Notes to set things up for the future. Whilst it takes a bit of time to set up, many people are moving to this system because what it does is help you to create a framework around your most basic application, turning it into more of a PKM journal research type application, which is going to help you to structure your notes into a better way and create some sort of system around how you take notes on Apple Notes. We're going to show you everything in this video, including how to set it up and all of the insights into getting started. Whilst it won't show you every little detail, it'll show you the basics of what you need to know about Forever Notes, and there's much more resources that we'll dig deeper into. My name is Francesco D'Alessio, and welcome to the Toolfinder YouTube channel. So, before we begin, a very simple overview of this concept, because it's important to understand what it can do for you and how it works. This concept is called the Forever Notes concept, and it's a layer over your Apple Notes to better help you to organize and structure your account. The idea was developed with an inspiration around the Second Brain and Ryder Carroll's bullet journal concept. And Mateus wanted to create a concept that allows you to stick with your Apple Notes for longer and also create a system that you can stick with Apple Notes that is typical inside of other apps like Obsidian, Roam, and Evernote, and many more. So what are the benefits of using this concept? Well, it gives you a homepage to your Apple Notes, which allows you then to go into it every single day and find relevant things. It also gives you the ability to plan projects, to manage a journal, and also to go deeper with some of your goals and targets all through your Apple Notes, as well as target milestones and tasks as well, all nested in the same place. The benefit as well is that this is going to be free, and if you're on iOS and Mac, it's going to be synchronized across devices and be a much more of a structured framework for you. So we're gonna do a full guide on how to use this in this video to help you fully understand it. Before we begin, please do make sure you hit subscribe and also check out our buyer's guide to note-taking apps if you want to expand beyond Apple Notes or you're interested in better managing how you use it. Let's get started. So let's get started with creating your Forever Notes experience in Apple Notes. And I'm going to be doing this, giving you guides throughout this. So I recommend getting a cup of tea and getting started with this. Now, if you're a McLaren fan, there will be a Ferrari in the background, so I do apologize, but this is a good view for setting up your Apple Notes. So let's get stuck in. Now, you probably notice I'm not actually on the Apple Notes app, and that's because with this system, you have to start inside of going to settings, go to general, go to keyboard, then go to text replacement. Now, the reason you do this is because you want to change that double asterisk into a really big asterisk. And the importance behind that is you want this to be much easier to search. So inside of your account, it turns anything that's created into that. Now, to skip a little bit of step, the best thing to do is to create a folder called Forever Notes. And the idea behind this is so that everything is stored in here. It's a little bit more organized. You will be able to create more folders. Don't worry, we'll get to that. And this will save a bunch of time. Now, if you go and press a new note, then we're gonna go ahead and create the homepage. Now, the homepage is really simple. We're gonna do that double asterisk and we're gonna call it home. Everything's built around this asterisk concept. It's a little bit like bullet journaling because obviously that asterisk will help you find things, but it also follows some of the ideologies around that. So what do you add to your homepage? It's a little bit different because what we're able to add is a calendar, things called hubs, and things called resources. But your homepage can be built up of anything that's easily accessible to you. So you can, if you want, cheat and build a homepage from scratch, or you can cheat by creating a homepage using one of their commands. So there's actually a shortcut, which you can actually find as part of the link in description, that if you press the homepage shortcut, it's gonna go ahead and create one of these homepages for you. Now, obviously it's not gonna be in this folder, so let's go and find it. It's up here. And as you can see, it's pretty much a worked homepage for you. Now, you can start to see some of the details, like they've added a lovely header image, projects, hubs, and also people and resources, which we'll come to. So this might be a good starting point for you to get the basics in, but it won't obviously be your final product because you're going to refine this and make this better. So the next thing that they recommend doing as part of this system is to create what's called tags. Now, obviously tags are well known in productivity for helping you to organize where things go. So let's go ahead and create a few tags to get you started. So I think one of the best things to do is start listing your tags at the bottom of the homepage. Now, the idea behind this is to start populating the tags. For example, you can add anything that's correlated to things that you're going to add to your system. So in this case, it could be recipes, reference, projects, etc. But it's an idea around setting up these that will help you to organize the structure of your account. So when we get these started and in, you'll start to see that you can use the smart folders to help organize these in a better fashion. So those are some of the basics that I want to go ahead and create. So as you can see at the bottom here, I've got a few of the tags, and tags only exist if you keep them as part of your or one page at least. So they won't detect any tags if you don't have it in your account. So the best thing to do is to start making some smart folder collections based on these. So for example, in my case, I wanted an upcoming trips folder. So in this case, I'm going to go ahead and press this folder icon and I'm going to call it trips. So if I press make it a smart folder, what I'm going to choose here is a tag, and I'm going to choose a selected tag and I'm going to press trip. And once I press done, as long as the criteria I'm happy with, for example, you can add 2024 trips or those sort of things and add more filters to help you narrow it down. But I'm going to go ahead and press done. So there we go. There's my first ever collection. And you can do this with whatever you want. I'm actually going to do a run through of how I would set this up nearer the end. But you can also sort it by, for example, trips that are coming up, etc. Obviously, you can see my home note is showing now. But obviously, when I add and begin to add more trips, it will start to populate and I can remove that tag from the home page for later. One other way you could do it is call a page tags and add all of the tags that you've created inside of here, as not to keep it on the home page and almost have a directory-like experience inside of your account. So you can do this for whatever you want. The collections can be used for books, ideas, thoughts, even projects that you're working on and people that you interact with quite often. But tags are going to help you to structure your account later on. So the next thing to do is something called hubs, and hubs are a bit more of a grounded experience in your account. They indicate that they're more of a resource. So for example, I'm going to create a hub called fitness goals. So I'm going to give it a hashtag hub. And now when I come to my fitness goals, I can set this up a little bit later to break it down in more detail. So you can have as many hubs as you want. And once I am going to add my Hyrox training, finance and other goals as part of my work. But you can also add projects as well. I will be adding house repairs and scrum planning, something we're launching soon. And you can also have a journal too. So now we've created a home area and a tags area. Collections you can also create as well through those smart folders. You've also got hubs. There's also the journal area. Now, to be honest, the journal area is a little bit more complicated. For example, I think the best place to start is by creating Q1, Q2, Q3, and Q4, and also the 12 months of the year. Now, this is can be created from the home area and added at a later date if you find it more suitable. I actually used one of their iOS shortcuts that they created to setting this up, but it actually went and created 365 dates in the calendar for every single day, which I found really, really stressful. I don't know about you, but you could do that concept, or you just could create them at the same time or link them as you go. So maybe it's best if you run this, it does take a few minutes to get through, and in the background, start using all of these to link to them. And I'll show you how that's done. The journal part, in my opinion, is probably the most exciting element of it because you can create it how you like. So let's go to the homepage that I created earlier. And one of the things that I can do straight away is remove some of these elements at the bottom. Now that we have a tags area, we don't need those tags at the bottom. And you can start to see this hubs area is becoming more useful. Now, because I created the health area, what I can do is actually go over to add link. So I actually called it fitness goals, but you can start to see if I do the user double asterisk and find it here, I can change it to that title and press done.
So now I've got an entry, my first ever hub all connected up to my homepage. So it's a good starting point if I'm building out my hubs area. Now, if I go down and I make some space, I can also create the calendar area, which will become my journal in a moment. So in this case, I need to connect up the Q1, which is the start of the year. And it's something that I imported through that iOS shortcuts, which I'll include a link in the description. Now you can press two right arrows and find stuff much faster. And then that means that I can go over, add those two asterisks and type in Q1. And there we go. I've got a linked note automatically. Now what they do in their start of their account is they add in items like this. Now if you do want, you don't have to have that link look here. You can actually have it as more of a raw link if you want. And what I can do here is link to Jan. So in this case, I can link here to January, which was created, February, because that's part of Q1, and March, because that's part of Q1 too. All I can do is go to add link and type in January. And in this case, I'm not going to set that as the note title's name and press done. So as you can see, it links a little bit more efficiently than they do on their websites. So this is starting to look a little bit neater, and you can populate this down here with Q2 and the 3 months as part of it. And as you can imagine, it takes a little bit of time to load. Now, say I was in January. Now, this is what the January looks like. And because I imported this, it does look slightly weird. And as you can see, it hasn't really populated it properly. Now, this was much more complicated to do, and I'd recommend taking a look at the website because this takes a little bit of time and I don't think the import fully mastered this. What I recommend doing is starting to use this area for things like your goals. So inside of your account, as you're using this journal, there are a few different things. There's signifiers, and the signifiers can be a great way to modify your details as well in the account. So there are a few different signifiers. If you were to add a checklist item, that would indicate that you are using a milestone. If you were to add a dash, that would be in the form of a note. If you add a dash with some of the highlighting elements, that would be important. And 1, 2, 3, 4 are all priority items. That's how they recommend the structure to be in your account. If you've got an event, they recommend adding just one asterisk to indicate that the asterisk comes up. So in this case, even though it's not an event, I could put UFC event, and that would be deemed as an event. It's more of a visual way to help define the details. So if I go back to the homepage, now I can start modifying some of the details in here. For example, if I did have a kitchen renovation, what I can do is actually link it to that relevant note. And as you can see, that started to link to that kitchen renovation details here. So here's another one. If I wanted to add a bunch of people, for example, persons mentioned, I could use the smart filter to bring that tag along. But if I had more people that are at mentioned as part of my iMessage, I can bring those in too. In this case, let's go ahead and create an area called people. Now, in order to create a person, then what I'm gonna have to do is press the plus button, and say I wanted to add my wife, then I would have to add person below her and then start adding details about it. For example, I can add in here things that I need to do, goals and other elements like that. And as that's now a person in my account, I could even add a icon and make things look a little bit different. Now inside of my homepage, I could then go to this first part and type in Becca and add the link so that I'm able to see and add a bit of detail to it. Now, I guess if I wanted to as well, I could add a little bit of emoji to this as well. For example, a heart, and I could add done at the top and go back. And in my homepage, it should come up with a little bit of emoji as well to add a little bit of spice to the page. So this is the very basics of getting started with this. There's actually a lot more that you need to comprehend and understand. And setting this up might take a little bit of time. It's actually taken 15 minutes to get to even this point. So I would probably recommend setting in 1 hour to fully get in the homepage, the tags, the collections, the hubs, the journals, the signifiers, and get started with the backlinks. My recommendation is obviously 1 hour. Once you set this up, you'll go from here, and you can probably add stuff as you go. Adding things like tags at a later date is a lot easier. For example, if you start reading books, using hashtag tags, then creating a smart folder for books is probably a lot easier. And then things like adding hubs. The calendar is probably the most difficult place. For example, in this Q1 area, I would have to indicate that this is Q1 of 2024, but I could scratch this if I did want to. And some of these elements here, you might have to build out from using the guide that they provided online. It's a little bit choppy, but at the same time, you could start using it. Now onto that journal element that I was talking about as well. Say it was January 1st and I did want to write a journal entry. Because I imported that earlier from, for example, the iOS shortcuts thing, I could then do this, search for the 1st of January. And if I'm able to scroll and find it, then I can click into it and I could start writing my journal for that day ahead. For example, I could say, walked with Becca, and I could start writing details about this. So what's helpful as well is I'm naturally able to see all of the different relationships between these notes as well. So that's how I recommend about going to use the journal function. It might be a little bit more difficult longer term because you might have to recreate these each year and run the script each year, but all that you would have to do is add the actual date behind it. And you can see January 2024 comes in, and then you press done and you can have it linked obviously directly to the January folder. So all I'd have to do is add 2024 here. So there's a lot of things that you can do in terms of customizations with the journal. And this is really just a starting point to give you a structure, but hopefully that's given you an idea of the account. If you want to see my full Apple Notes Forever Notes, you can find it linked below if you're interested. How far I got up to and a few screenshots that you might find important. But this system is quite helpful. The final thing that you might be asking yourself is how do I get some of these images? I'll also link them below as the creator has naturally brought some stuff in so that you can save time adding these items in. So that's Forever Notes, and it's an interesting structure to your Apple Notes. This homepage connects calendars, projects, hubs, and people using backlinks and to better organize how you structure them. So thank you very much, and I hope this helped you set up your Forever Notes.